getting the suitcase off. Trinity, she's helping. She does everything. Literally, a week ago, she was sewing us costumes in the basement out of, like, a dress that we bought at a truck stop. Oh, my goodness. How are you doing for real? Let me tell you how we're doing. Because we have been trapped in a moving box on wheels with 6 to 7 other drag queens and 4 to 5 homosexuals for the last 3.5 weeks. So we're doing fucking amazing. Who knew in these trying times that true paradise was to be found on a late 90s tour bus, traveling through America, helping us live our To Wong Fu Feng Shui and Julie Newmar fantasies? So far without the bus breaking down. I mean, we have yet to see. We can do everything on the bus. There's a bathroom and everything. We can't shit there. But someone did. God. And this is a mystery that has been consuming us for the last week, because not only did they shit once, they continue to shit despite multiple warnings. And last night, we noticed. We noticed. So has anyone here used Reddit? Anyone? You all are good Nancy Drews. Can you figure out who shit on the bus for us, please? We have to solve this case. We have to. Oh gosh, there's so many amazing places on the bus. There's a room called the Rear Lounge. The Rear Lounge is where it's at. That's where all the good conversations happen. This morning I woke up in our little like 3.5 foot bunks, and I noticed a spot on the ceiling where I had hit my head 40 to 50 times. And good news, I learned that I have an oily skin type. But I chose to see it as like a little bit of a metaphor for these times. Let's not get so comfortable in our everyday situations when they are extreme and absurd and confining that we do not wake up in the middle of the night and hit our head on the ceilings forgetting where we are, right? Yeah. So as we metaphorically hit our heads on the ceilings of this strange world in which we live, and really hit our head on the ceilings because we live in a tour bus now, let's all heal ourselves by putting on some drags and getting a queer old time, right? Did anyone else here come up in drags? Did anyone come in drags? Okay, that is a meager yelling because, as Mama Ru herself said, you're born naked and the rest is what?
Drag!
So every motherfucking person here is up in drags, whether you like it or not. So if you are not fully realizing your fantasy of beauty and contour and highlight and cinching and hair or baldness, then I suggest you go out and throw on more glitter and shave yourself and cinch and pad and contour until you can present a kind of beauty and fantasy that the world needs to see, because we need more beauty. I love you so much. You're a fantastic, fantastic audience. I'll see you after the break. Love you!
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to step away for a brief 20-minute intermission.